Please welcome Hugh Hefner. Hugh Hefner.
It's a pleasure.
Huh?
No, you don't do this very often, and that's why it's special that you're here. Hef, may I call you Hef?
You may.
Okay, and you can call me Larry.
Okay, Larry.
Tell me how you select these women. I've always wished that I could be in on that selection process. Well, how does this all start?
Well, it begins with pictures coming into the magazine, and sometimes by photographers, sometimes the girls themselves send the pictures in. And if they look promising, then test shots are made.
Mm-hmm.
And if the test shots look promising, then they go ahead and do the,
I see,
the centerfold.
Now, you don't have any of those test shots with you, do you?
I don't. I...
Now, you're married now, right?
I am indeed.
Mm-hmm. And
with two small boys.
Two small boys. Mm-hmm. So future yes. Playboys, so to say. How does your wife deal with the business? Because after all, you're surrounded by just gorgeous women. Is that ever a problem?
Well, remember, she was a Playmate of the Year.
Well, I didn't want to say anything,
that's
but...
That's right. That's right.
Yeah, we've all seen her. And you're a lucky man. Very lucky man. Good for you.
Yes.
How did you meet her?
Well, she happened to be... As a matter of fact, she was already in the magazine. And her centerfold already appeared. And she was here... in Los Angeles, staying at the mansion,
mm-hmm.
shooting a pictorial with Helmut Newton.
So did you just bump into her at the mansion?
Yes. I asked her if she wanted, we were watching a movie one night, and I asked her if she wanted to watch a film with me.
Now, this is great. You have this great advantage because these women are in your house to begin with. These women are in your house.
I've already seen test photos.
And you've seen test
yes.
photos. So kind of like you're walking, maybe you're going to the kitchen to get something from the fridge, mm-hmm. and you bump into Miss January.
Yes, that's the way it is. That's the way it is.
And you say, hey, that's about all you need to say, because you're
hey.
Yeah, hey is all you need.
All right. We'll come right back before Hugh Hefner. Stay tuned. Don't stick around.
You have a little hair there coming down. All right, when we come back, we'll go into this area about your wife being jealous about your work.
I'd rather stay away from that.
Excuse me, Hef. Doing great.
Thank you.
I just want you to know that it's just an honor to be this close to you.
Thank you very much, Frank.
You know what? In my bedroom, in a box next to my bed, I have every tape of every Playboy After Dark ever made.
Oh, I take that as a real compliment.
Yes. You know, I do quite a lot of reading about the parties at the mansion. That would be a hoot to be invited to one of those.
Imagine it would be.
Darlene, have some water.
No, thank you.
Go ahead, I don't have anything.
No, really.
Thank you.
Who is that?
Well, that's my assistant, Darlene Cipini. She's from Madison, Wisconsin, and her hobbies include
is he bothering
horseback
you?
Riding,
he's bothering
movies.
Her? Yeah, he is, isn't he? I'm sorry.
She's a cancer.
But Jesus, did you see the way Hank was all over Hefner? He did everything but hump his leg.
You must have looked away for a second. You know, I have to get going because. You know where my keys are?
Well,
yeah, I got them. I have to get my place ready for the Architectural Digest people.
But that's late tomorrow.
Yeah, but, you know, I want it to look, perfect.
I've never seen you get so excited over a piece of publicity.
It's Architectural Digest. I always wanted my house in there ever since I saw, you know, Carson's place.
Oh, Johnny Carson's. That was a wonderful house.
Great house.
Yes, you used to be able to stand on the roof and watch Angie Dickinson sunbathe.
You know, the problem I have is Francine doesn't want to be in any of the photos.
Uh-huh.
Well, what do you think I should do?
Oh, no. I refuse to get involved in this. Absolutely no.
Well, all right. But you're coming over a little later, right?
In about an hour. You want me to bring anything?
You know what? There's a plant on the talk show set, just to my left, the
your
big
left.
One. Yeah, you want your...
What about this one? This is a Mediterranean ficus. It's a very classy plant. Look perfect next to your fireplace.
Think so?
Yeah.
No.
Darlene, after many years of trying, Hank Kingsley is going to appear in Playboy.
You got the interview. I knew it would happen someday, Hank. I am so happy for you.
Well, thank
this
you.
This is great.
Thank you. It's not the interview. It's a feature about women who work in television.
But Hank, you're a man.
Right. But you're a woman. Now it's a piece, and it's called The Sidekick's Sidekick, and it has some shots of you and me in the office and on the set and out on the town, and mostly it is a spread about you.
They want me to pose?
Sorry? Pose? Yeah.
Naked?
Naked. You know, I didn't ask, but I would assume, yeah. You know.
I'm flattered, Hank, but I just don't...
Right.
This would...
But hear me out. Hear me out. Because I said but at first also. Sit down, Darlene. You see, Darlene, my dad, Henry Kingsley Sr., was a charter subscriber to Playboy. He adored that magazine and all that it stood for.
Sweet.
And now I finally have the chance to make my dad proud.
Your dad's passed away, isn't he, Hank?
We think so. We're not sure. He left when I was 7. Anyway... I know wherever he is, he's watching. And I know it would mean a lot to him. Mm. But look, if appearing in Playboy makes you uncomfortable, I'm sure Pop would understand. Would you at least please, would you think about it, okay? Artie, how can I help you?
Sit up.
Yes, sir.
Before you left, Hef told me about this little idea of yours. All I can say is be careful.
Oh, Artie. It'll be very tasteful. No bush.
Listen to me, Hank. I want you to keep this very low profile. Larry Sanders is the star here, goddammit.
All right, Artie. I hear you.
Low profile.
Well, I don't know why you can't be in the picture. It's one little picture. It's the little insert that they put up in the corner. It's tiny. It's smaller than a wallet size photo.
I'm not going to be in the picture. I don't live here. I'm not your wife. This isn't my house.
Okay.
I'm not going to
okay.
do it.
Okay. All right.
I don't see why.
You're right.
Okay.
But, you know, the magazine doesn't come out for another 2 months. Maybe things will be different by then.
Well, you're asking me to move in with you?
Yes, in my own, I can't believe I did it that way myself way. Yes, I am, I guess.
Well, I'm not going to be in the picture.
Well, fine, but let's talk about the moving in.
Now, I don't want anyone to think I had anything to do with decorating this house.
Well, what is that supposed to mean?
I don't know.
Well, wait a minute. Are you saying you don't think this house is in good taste?
Right, that's what I'm saying. I don't think this house is in good taste. That's
well,
what I'm getting at. I'm just look around.
Why?
I mean, all right, look. What is this?
That is a head carved out of rock.
This place looks like the junior suite in the Four Seasons.
Thank you. Jeannie and I met at the Four
Seasons. Oh, gladiolas will liven things up.
Oh, gosh.
Ah, you're all set, kiddo.
Artie doesn't want to be in the picture.
Huh? Oh, well, that's an area I will not get involved in.
Bye, Larry. I'll see you later. Bye, Artie.
Bye. Now, if you'll excuse me, I know a lovely place for this African violet.
Where are you going to put it?
In the crapper.
Will you not talk that way when the Architectural Digest people are here?
Did you do the test photos?
Yeah. It really wasn't that bad. There was no one there but me and the photographer.
Some slime bag, right?
No. She seemed nice.
She?
What did they make you wear?
Oh, come on. You're not actually going to do this, are you?
Look, Hank really wants me to do this, and I owe him a lot.
Oh, so you're doing this for Hank?
If it wasn't for Hank, I would still be being sawed in half by the amazing Clifford for two shows a night.
You know what, Darlene? The more I hear about this, it sounds to me like there's very little difference between Hank and the amazing Clifford.
Clifford probably dresses better. Come on, you guys.
You come on. You know, you're being exploited and used, and you don't even know it.
Here's those Playboy After Dark tapes you wanted.
Oh, great.
Right. Now, you want to pay attention to Mort Saul, because you could learn something. What was that?
What?
No. Well, you're hiding something from me.
No, we're not.
Yes, you are.
We're working on the monologue.
Yeah, no, you're not.
Look, if we were hiding something from you, you would not know. But should we show him?
Yeah, show me.
We have Darlene's test photos.
How did you get those?
They were right on our desk. They were sitting there in a big envelope with a Playboy bunny on it, and we just thought it was a new issue.
Who are they?
Good.
No, no, this is not good. This is not right. This is not our property. Oh, my God.
Hank, your agent's on the phone. Where did you get those? Hank?
I got it on the desk.
And you thought you could just take them and show them around?
Like, Darlene?
That's rough. That's rough. Oh, wait. Let me see.
I'm not going to be exploited and used.
Oh, come on, Darlene. This is Playboy we're talking about. We're not talking about Hustler or Penthouse or Swank or Jugs or Screw.
Shh. Hey. You promised me that you would keep this very low profile?
Yes, I am.
Oh, bullshit. Shouting out the names of some of this country's finest men's publications outside the ladies' crapper is not low profile. Now listen, Miss Bernadette Peters just happens to be down that hallway in her dressing room.
You know, I wasn't shouting. Maybe it was that weird intern carrying on like that again. Yeah. That's why they call him the weird intern, you know.
Hey,
yeah?
If you think it's so great, why don't you show everyone your tits?
Lower profile out there, you two.
You gotta be in the picture. Oh, don't make me sit in the living room all alone. I'll look like Harvey Korman.
Oh, so the only reason you want me in the picture is because you're worried about how you're gonna come off, so it's for you.
No. Well, look, okay, so I'm worried about how I'll come off, but you're worried about how you'll come off, so really, we want the same thing.
I don't want to be in this picture as an appendage.
Okay, fine. Then you move in, then you're not an appendage. Then you're there as a person who has moved in.
Oh, no one's ever asked me to move in before.
Wait a minute. How did you end up living with what's-his-name then?
Well, you know, you're dating and
yeah.
Then you're together, and then you're just kind of living together.
Well, all right, that's a good way. But you can't count on that way. This way, you take the picture, then you move in.
Oh,
that's a
no,
better way.
You don't know how much I hate having my picture taken.
You still think that it takes a little of your... Artie, come here. Come here. Come here, Artie. Artie, please talk to her about the picture, please.
No, I cannot get involved in this area.
You got to talk to her about it.
Artie, why don't you be in the picture?
Just what? Larry and me in a decorating magazine? Oh, no, no.
No, people might get the wrong idea, huh?
I would.
Yeah. Wouldn't a picture of me and her look really
yes,
nice?
Yes, with your arm around your lady with a big bouquet of baby's breath behind you. Whoa, Hersey, whoa. Hey. You've got me sucked in for a second.
Artie, wait, come back. Brad Pitt's in the green room. I'm going to go see if he's as cute as everybody says he is.
You're going to be disappointed. You'll see.
Is she moving in?
I don't know. Come here a minute. Do you think my house is too feminine?
You want me to send over a couple of my trophy heads?
No, but you know, don't you have that chair with the teeth or something?
Antlers and bones, yeah. Actually. Might look good on the sun deck.
Yeah, bring that.
Yeah, sure. I don't know. That's a hard decision, Darlene.
I don't know what to do. I don't want to look stupid.
Believe me, you won't. Standing next to Hank, you'll come off looking like Carl Sagan.
Are you sure?
Positively. You know, I've never told many people about this, but I knew Marilyn Monroe. We were friends.
Really?
Yeah. A lovely, bright, sensitive woman. She's very self-conscious till she learned how to use her beauty as an asset.
I'm no Marilyn Monroe.
Well, you're mighty nifty, sweetie. What I'm trying to say is, you gotta use what you're born with. Now look at me. I've got a face that would crack a mirror. That's why I'm a producer.
Marilyn did Playboy, didn't she?
If you're going to do this, you've got to do it for yourself and for no one else, especially not for fucking Hank.
Then I can do it.
That's up to you.
For myself. Thanks. I can't wait to tell Hank. Thanks, Artie.
No. Hello, Miss Exploited and Used.
Hank, I came to talk to you about the Playboy piece.
Well, you're going to be very happy. They killed it.
What?
No, Hef bounced the idea off of some editor and he nixed it.
What didn't they like?
I tell you this. That magazine was built on ideas like the sidekick sidekick. And it is not a circa 1975 idea. It is money in the bank, Frank.
They hated my test shots, didn't
they? Oh, those fuckers! Those fuckers! Bunch of sleazebags, every one of them. Oh, God, it just would have been so great.
What did they say about me?
About you? Oh, they loved you. They wanted to know if you were interested in doing a pictorial alone.
I am interested, Hank.
What?
I want to do it for me, not for you, but for me, I want to do it. What are you doing, Hank?
Okay, here's what we're going to do.
What?
You're going to call them, and you're going to say to them, now, look, I am not going to do a pictorial unless Hank Kingsley is part of it.
Hank, come on, I'm sorry. I did the best I could.
Who'd you talk to?
I talked to the editor himself.
Well, what did he say?
Hank, I'm sorry. I know this was a dream of yours and your pop's.
Oh, it's not just my pop. Don't you understand? I have a restaurant opening in less than 2 months. I put everything into it, just everything. If I don't get some publicity, you know who's going to be at the gala opening? You, me, the creditors, and that's it.
Hank? Maybe I could wear one of those Hank Look Around Cafe t-shirts in one of the shots.
Yeah, you see, it's very hard to pose nude and wear a t-shirt at the same time. In fact, it's downright impossible. Well, great. I've become pissy.
You know what?
Well, if it isn't my two favorite Playboy models, especially you, my dear.
Thank you. Excuse me.
So, hey, Hank, you've been keeping it low profile?
Artie, they cut me out, those cocksuckers.
Oh, I'm sorry, Hank. It's America's loss.
Want to get a drink?
Oh, I'd love to, sweetheart, but I've got to get over to Larry's house.
Larry's? Well, what's up?
Oh, come on. It's just one little picture. What difference does it make? Come on.
Oh, I don't want to waste any more time arguing about this. Where do you want me?
Oh, well, if you really don't want to do
this,
you don't
have
to.
No, just get this over with. Sit down.
Okay.
Over here. You want me over here?
Okay. All right. This is perfect. Are you going to wear this?
I'll get that. Max, with the lighting in here, I'd use an F8 stop.
Thanks, Artie.
Hey. Oh, Hank, we're a little busy here tonight.
Oh gosh. You are busy. I'm sorry. I had no idea.
It's Hank Kingsley. Might be fun if we got some shots of you and Hank on the couch.
When are you moving in?
Oh,
have you
come
moved
on over
yet?
And sit down, Hank.
Okay.
I don't want him in the picture.
Oh, come on, Larry. The more the merrier. Sit down, Hank. Great.
You drive a hard bargain, madam.
I don't want a picture.
Just a little, just yammer.
Okay, everybody. Say hey now.
Right now.
Love, Darlene. There you go.
Architectural Digest is great.
Yeah, right.
This is fucking bad timing that Darlene's article had to come out the same day as yours.
Okay.
Otherwise, everyone would be bent over your desk instead of over Darlene's.
Have you seen it?
Yes, it's right here. It's nothing special. You see one, you've seen them all. But how many houses do you see like this?
Jesus.
These lilies on a coffee table, that's a sexy touch. Has Francine seen this?
I don't know.
Has she moved in yet?
I don't know. She's there every night. I don't know if she's moved in, Artie. Have you talked to Hank?
No.
Does he know that it's not my fault that he was cropped out of that?
He'll be fine.
Even though she owned a motorcycle.
I already signed yours.
Hank, have you seen my Playboy pictorial yet?
Very nice. Congratulations.
Hank, I wore the Hank's Look Around Cafe t-shirt in the main shot. It's a little ripped, but you can still read it.
Very nice.
I thought you would like it.
I guess you didn't hear there was a small grease fire at the site last night.
Oh, my God.
No. It's only going to push us back about, 10 months. Hey. It's a new architectural digest. Fuckers.
Low profile, hey?
Bunch of fuckers.
Martin deals with an ex-flame and gets his hands burnt in Dream On next. Then at 12:50, the actor John Cusack is tonight's special guest on The Late Show.